Good afternoon, everybody. Susan Bohorick here, Centera Susan, on your Friday afternoon. Thanks so much for joining us today. Well, February is American Heart Month, and for a lot of folks, it is a very special time to raise awareness about different heart conditions. We have a cardiologist here with us today, Dr. Rabia Arshad. Not only is she a cardiologist, she is going to be our co-keynote speaker in the upcoming event, the Red Dress Luncheon, at the end of this month. A very exciting, fun event. But first off, let's talk a little bit with Dr. Arshad. Dr. Arshad, thank you for joining us today.
Absolutely.
You are a cardiologist. And tell me a little bit, there's all different specialties. Mm-hmm. What is your niche and specialty, and what does that mean for the layperson?
Sure. So when it comes to the heart, we usually evaluate the heart in a couple of different ways, and that's the heart arteries, the muscles of the heart, the valves of the heart, the electricity of the heart. All of these things sort of go into cardiovascular care. So general cardiology and non-invasive cardiology, we're the cardiologists who see every one of those categories, and we also help to predict who's going to fall into that category, and that's called preventative cardiology. So a lot of our work is seeing patients in the office, doing echoes, stress tests, and so on, helping evaluate people even before their disease has begun.
For a lot of folks, is that, okay, I have a, you know, a personal genetic history and tie, or have I had an episode, maybe a shortness of breath, mm-hmm. maybe a blacking out episode? What does that usually look like when they come to you?
Sure. So cardiac symptoms can be very vague. In particular, in women, they can be very unusual. Typical angina is elephant fits sitting on your chest. So basically, chest tightness that comes on when you're exerting yourself, and it goes away when you sit down or do something else. In women, that sensation can be very strange. So it can be a chest pressure, it can be just a feeling of lightheadedness, fatigue, shortness of breath, perspiration, extra beats. So all of these things can be cardiac symptoms. And again, you know, what's most important is to try and evaluate if any of these symptoms are exertional. So if you can bring them on by walking or by exercising and so on, that's typically quite telling for a cardiac symptom.
Yeah. Now, excuse me, I had a little frog in my throat there. One thing that's really exciting is that this is a family affair for you and your sister. Mm-hmm. It's exciting, I think, because, boy, your family must be proud. Two cardiologists and these two women, strong, smart ladies, and they're going to be our co-keynote speakers at the event on the 28th. I know for both you and your sister, you are so interested and so involved in raising the awareness, especially for women, and getting the word out there, especially because you know, women are always taking care of everybody else, and sometimes they put their own health to the back burner.
That's absolutely correct, and I think that's why February is such an important month for us. So this is the one month in the year that every woman should probably prioritize her own health, and specifically that means cardiovascular health, because of course it's the leading killer of women in particular. And so that's a key thing to remember for February.
What do you tell your patients when they come to you, or women in your life, just to kind of hammer it home for them?
Right. So just, I think it's a good idea for us all to remember that we're all on four steps, right? One is having risk factors. The other is managing risk factors. The third is having the disease. And the fourth is managing the disease. So everybody's somewhere on that spectrum. And you have to make sure that wherever you are, you have both identified the risks to yourself and also modified them as much as possible.
Okay. You know, so perhaps you're carrying an extra 15 pounds around, mm-hmm. perhaps you're a smoker, perhaps you're a drinker, perhaps you're eating a lot of like high fat foods, mm-hmm. fried foods, you know, I guess some of them are kind of obvious. Hey, try to be more active. Mm-hmm. Hey, try to have a better diet. Hey, don't be afraid of vegetables. Sure. You know, and then I guess there also comes into the genetics also goes into that.
Yes. So diet and exercise is always step one, step two, right? But everybody with a perfect diet and a really good exercise regimen isn't going to look exactly the same way. Right. And also they're not going to have the same risk factor modification. But the key thing to remember is everybody gets cardiovascular protection through eating well and through exercising regularly. That's true for every single person. So a good idea is to try and get some sort of cardiovascular exercise for 20 to 30 minutes every single day. And in terms of diet, there's a lot of fad diets, and you don't necessarily need to be on one versus the other, but some general principles hold true. And that is, you want to avoid the super toxic food groups. So that's fried food, sugar, and salt. You want to, you know, cut down for the most part, because most of us have more carbohydrates in our diet than we need. So the bread, rice, potatoes, pasta family, you really do want to cut down on those. And then the healthy family, which is mainly vegetable protein, you can have as much of that as you like, really, for most people. And chicken, fish, turkey, you know, sort of unfried, unsalted, not served with cheese, that's a reasonable food group too, and you can have as much of that as you like for most people too.
How come she hit on all the things that I like? I love that bread. You know I love that bread. That cheese, delicious. And I don't think I've ever met a French fry I don't like. So these are all sure. real uh-huh. things that we know and that we should maybe be following. For those who are thinking about it, mm-hmm. February 28th, exciting. Yes. We're going to have the Red Dress Luncheon, third year in a mm-hmm. row. Why are you excited to be involved?
So again, as I mentioned, you know, a lot of this seems obvious. It's just that people don't prioritize it. So for one thing, February is a very good time for people to say, okay, what shape is my heart in? What are my risk factors like? What have I done to kind of bring down those risk factors? So it's a great way for us to just remind people of some of the things they already know. And then secondly, not everybody is on the same page yet, you know, so a lot of people, for a lot of people, it might be the first time that they hear some very, very key concepts, like know your numbers. That's a very key concept. Mm-hmm. Know your numbers essentially means your blood pressure, your overall cholesterol, your specific very bad cholesterol, which is the LDL cholesterol, your weight in inches, your body mass index. These are all very, very basic things. You don't need to be in a physician's office to know these things. Everybody should know where their body is right now and how they can get it to a better place. So February is a good time for us to highlight all of that.
Wonderful. Dr. Arshad, thank you so much for talking with me. I know you're very busy, so I thank you for speaking with us. Dr. Arshad touched on a couple of really good points here, and I'm going to let her go because I know she's doing some paperwork and dealing with patients. But we are offering our Know Your Numbers. It is on our Facebook page. You can go to also centera.com. It's right there on the front page once you put your location in. So just put that information in, and you can kind of see where you are. Also, February 28th, there are still tickets available. I'm going to put a link up on this Facebook Live, and you can go there. You need to register. It is a $25 donation that goes directly to the American Heart Association. Ladies, this is going to be a really great afternoon, not only a fellowship, but of some really great education, great information, and just kind of, maybe it's stuff you know, maybe it's stuff you don't know, but bottom line, it could be information that could save your life or could save someone you love live, someone you love their life as well. Boy, that's a tongue twister, isn't it? All right, everybody, it's Friday. Have a wonderful weekend. Please be careful out there, and we'll see you at the Red Dress Luncheon at Matchbox at Potomac Mills Mall on February 28th. It's a Thursday, and be sure to register. We'll see you then. Bye-bye.